It's carnival season in New Orleans, and this old, storm-battered city is immersing itself in familiar traditions.
Before Katrina, it was just like, I was just to have fun, but now it's like, it's a meaning to this, to the city.
It's a time for brassy marching bands and high school majorettes strutting their stuff.
Mardi Gras is a big piece of New Orleans, a real big piece of New Orleans.
There are crazy costumes and comical floats.
I've been looking at Mardi Gras since I'm a kid. I love it.
What makes it special?
I like the throws and I like to holler at them.
Went down in New Orleans.
Mardi Gras parades like these are a chance for people here in New Orleans to have some fun, blow off steam, and forget about everything that's happened over the past year and a half.
At Mardi Gras in 2007 after Katrina.
But there's something missing, more accurately, some people. The tens of thousands who fled the city after the hurricane and have been unwilling or unable to return. Some areas have changed little since the floodwaters receded. Empty streets, abandoned buildings, and vacant lots are all that are left of once vibrant neighborhoods. Experts now believe the New Orleans of the future may have only half as many people as it did before the storm hit. 440,000 people lived here before Katrina. Only 191,000 remain. Many of those who may never come back include the poorest New Orleanians, mostly African Americans. Tulane University geographer Richard Campanella mapped the storm's impact on the city's neighborhoods, both black and white.
And we might end up maxing out at perhaps 250,000. I see this as a cultural tragedy, primarily because those areas hit hardest by the floods tended to have populations that were more likely to be deeply rooted in local society.
The saddest statistic of all, perhaps, the city now has 69% fewer children 18 and under than before the flood. Losing so many people threatens the culture that makes New Orleans unique, its festivals, folklore, and celebratory spirit.
It's not that it's so much important that we have it, but it would really be unbelievably sad if it were canceled.
That would be an irreplaceable loss for America and the world. Rob Reynolds, Al Jazeera, New Orleans.